this is pi, and we know the value of pi is 3.1416, and there are a lot more numbers behind of it. But today I want to show you something different thing. I want to add one more pi with it. That means it is 2 pi. If I add another pi with it, it becomes 3 pi. And if I continue this series, then it becomes 4 pi, 5 pi, and I want to continue this series until infinity. Question is, what's the answer of this infinite series of pi? Well, this is not so complex, this is very simple. I have a unique way to solve this problem. Regardless your age or level of expertise in mathematics, after watching this video, you may feel like, aha, this is the secret. Let me introduce power of each pi one order higher than the previous one. That means this is pi, and that one become pi square, that is pi cube, pi to the power 4, pi to the power 5, and so on until the infinity. This is my question. What's the answer of this infinite series of pi? Do you know the answer? The answer of this series is so simple. I know a unique way, and that is pretty much interesting than your imagination. If you love mathematics, believe me, you will feel a lot of fun with this calculation. This video is brought to you by DataCamp. DataCamp is an online learning platform with plenty of data-related courses. More is coming at the end of this video. Well, let me show you how to calculate this infinite series of pi. Let us consider the summation of this series is equal to, let's say, any random parameters. Let's say summation of this series is equal to S. That means S is summation, which is equal to this series. Now, next statement, what I am going to do, S is equal to, I want to take 1 pi common from right hand side. So if I take 1 pi common, this statement become pi is 1, then this pi square become pi, pi cube become pi square, then this pi to the power 4 become pi cube, and this pi to the power 5 become pi to the power 4 plus pi to the power 5, and this series is continued similarly until infinity. Look at here, this is the interesting part of my calculation. Look at this part of this mathematical statement. This is exactly same as the previous line. That means this can be substituted by that, and that can be substituted by S. So this part can be replaced by S. That's why in next line I can write like this way, S is equal to pi 1 plus, this is exactly S, right? Then pi is multiplied by 1, pi times 1 is pi, pi S. Now S minus pi S is equal to pi. And next statement, I can take 1 S common from here. So S on S common means this become 1 minus this become pi on left hand side, and right hand side is only pi. That means S is equal to this pi divided by, it go down, that means 1 minus pi. Yes, this is the answer of this infinite series of pi. Is not it simple? It's so simple. Mathematics is not so complex, it's pretty much interesting, just it's combination of few data. And if you have interest and if you love mathematics, believe me, mathematics is not so complex. This video is sponsored by DataCamp. DataCamp is an interactive e-learning platform with a wide range of data science and programming language courses. DataCamp has short expert videos with built-in practice module that deliver personalized feedback on your individual task. All courses are taught by experts and range from importing data, data visualization, machine learning, deep learning, and many more. If you want to close your data skill gap, you should try DataCamp, no matter your age or level of expertise. Personally, I like Python programming language in DataCamp because I don't need to install any additional tools to write the code. If you want to work in a scientific environment like I do, Python programming language would help you a lot in future. Are you thinking about price? Don't worry, sign up to DataCamp by using the link given in the description of this video and check out the first chapter of any course for free. Thanks DataCamp for sponsoring this video. Well, don't go, I have one more interesting fact to show you about the mathematics. This is a square. The side length of this square is not given. Only the diagonal length of this square is given, which is, let's say it is x. So what's the total area of this square? We know the total area of this square. If we know the diagonal length, then total area of this square is x, that means diagonal length, over square root 2 and whole covered by square. This is the formula that is normally used to calculate the total area of a square if you know the diagonal length. But I have a very simplified way that can be used to calculate the total area of this square within 5 seconds. Believe me, that is very simple. First, let me show you an example according to your way or typical way, conventional way. Let's say this diagonal length x is equal to 5 divided by square root 2, then whole square. This 5 square is 25, and this square root and this square is removed, only remaining is 2. So 25 divided by 2, which is equals to 12.5. This is the answer of this total area if this diagonal length is 5. Let me show you my way that is more simplified than this typical or conventional way. My way is directly write this diagonal length, which is 5 here, and multiply this diagonal length by its half. That means half of 5 means 2.5. So 5 times 2.5, which is equals to 12.5. That is the Dijon. They are same. So tell me, which way is faster, this conventional way that you followed or my way? X is equal to 10. Then write this 10 here and multiplied half of this 10 is 5. That means 10 times 5 is 50. Yes, 50 square centimeter or meter, whatever it is, this is the answer. Is not it simple? Very simple. Let me give you another example. Let's say this diagonal length is 6. So my way is simply multiply this 6 by its half. That means 6 times 3, which is equals to 18. 18 square centimeter or 18 square meter. Let's take another example. Let's say 12. This diagonal length is 12. So what you have to do? Simply multiply it by 12 by its half. Half of 12 is 6. That means 12 times 6, which is equals to 72 square centimeter or square meter, whatever is the unit. So this is my way that is much more easy than the conventional way. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you subscribe this channel, and see you next time. Bye bye.